grab a cardboard.
Yeah, kind of. You're still hearing my voice because
could just use a cardboard tube from a pack of paper towels.
All right, Vasily, roll your initiative again.
We want to see how quickly you are standing out there in the hallway, Bernie.
Well, I'm putting everybody back in order, buddy.
Yeah, I know. I know, but he wasn't in the game here. He just guarding the hallway. Yeah.
All right, Vasily, it would be your turn.
Vasily was between Santacon and Burnham.
I thought he was near last.
I was right after Bertram.
Oh, okay, never mind. Be Serata's turn then. Serata, roll 2d6.
2d6?
Yes.
Flat. This is not going good for
Let's
me.
Roll one.
Because you're a ways down before the rung snapped. So you take 6 damage, bludgeoning damage.
Ow.
Hold on a second.
And now Zoe, roll 6 more.
Technically, he snaps a projectile because it's falling. It'd be 1d10. Oh no. It's a new world for me. Oh no.
Welcome to the next level. Roll a dexterity, Serato, roll a dexterity save with advantage. You see a light plummeting, like you land like on your back, and you're like, your wind's knocked out of you. And you look up, and then suddenly you see a light that's getting closer.
Fuck!
You rolled with advantage though, so it's all right. So you scramble out of the way as a dagger slams point first into the stone.
Can I throw it back up?
That was Steve.
It's still point first. It just clatters. Yes,
it would still would freaking hurt.
Yeah. He wouldn't take full damage, but it still I give the DM inspiration. I'll make sure to use my inspiration.
I scramble back over. I grab the dagger and I unsheath it. And I'm just like, hey! Toss it back up.
Yeah, it's like 50 feet up.
All right.
How far do you think a monk could throw? Should I make a dex check for that?
No, well, it'd be an attack roll. I forget the range on a dagger.
It's short. I think it's.
I know it's not very big. It's not very.
Yeah,
big.
It's like 10, 40, 30 feet or something. Might be 30.
It's 20-60, so it'll be disadvantaged.
20-60?
Yeah.
10. Okay.
Well, I'm not...
60 foot's pretty good.
So, what should I roll for that?
Just roll a regular attack roll.
Okay, so, I don't know, should I use my monk unarmed strike, or...?
Yeah, that's fine, because you'd have proficiency in a dagger, I believe.
Yeah.
15... 12. You can get it. You can get it up over the lip. Basically, okay, it won't hit. It won't hit anybody.
All right,
Zoe.
All right.
If
I can at
dagger.
Least poke someone like on the toe, I'm satisfied.
I pick up my dagger as it comes flying back. Are you okay down there? I shout.
So Zoe, you can see a door, across from where you were laying. And then it looks like a hallway goes north and south.
My ass hurts.
Quit stuffing that suppository up. Oops.
I say get back up here. We're not going down there yet.
But the ladder broke.
Well, we're tossing some rope down towards you.
I have the rope.
I have rope too.
Neat.
So that's what I'm doing on my turn. I'm gonna tie the rope off and toss it down. And then he can use the ladder. That would be faster, but if the ladder breaks again, we can pull him up.
Tie a noose in the end for him to put around him in case that ladder breaks.
You hung the halfling.
No, he hung himself by breaking the damn ladder again.
Alright, so I guess I'm going to start climbing up until I reach that broken spot. Then I don't know, can I jam my sickle in there? Like, use it as a step stool?
How big are these steps in there? You think it's like 7 foot per rung or something?
they're you know, normal space. By the way, Serata, you hear this sort of scraping, skittering sound that's getting closer and faster.
Oh, shit. Now I'm climbing these ladders as fast as I can. I'm like, help. That's,
it's not quite your turn yet.
Oh, no. Fuck. Whose turn is it, then?
Bertram.
Not quite.
Bertram. Now I have to jump back and forth between maps here.
Yeah. I have nothing to do. I will just down there. I mean, I have the best vision. See down that far.
You could see Serata at the bottom. And you hear, you know, you could probably hear him go, oh, shit.
Okay, I will ready an arrow to see if I can see anything to shoot at other than the monk, which I'll shoot at if I don't see anything else.
Okay. Are you silly? Maybe Vasily's not at his computer. I heard a kid.
I thought maybe you did, but I heard a kid.
Santa?
I kind of look at them and like, what are you guys doing?
I say the halfling fell down the hole.
You mean he's in the water?
It's an illusion.
I envision in my mind Santa Con is like B.A. Baracus in your room.
The what?
B.A. Baracus.
Ah, pity the fool. And I'm that fool, aren't I? Alright, I'm done.
I pity the fool that fall in the pool. So.
Well, I already tied the rope and stuff, so I'm just gonna start my tech magic thing again because I wanna find out what's in that coin. That like shiny silver coin.
Yeah, don't you have to like drop the rope down to tie it off correctly, Cat?
I tied it off.
So, unfortunately for Serato,
time to die.
So you see this big worm-looking thing. It has tentacles springing from its mouth, and it moves, advances on you, hungry.
Worm or centipede?
It's kind of wormish.
Okay.
With a thousand legs?
Yeah, it has a ton of legs.
Thanks,
more millipede-ish, man. I guess.
Okay, I really want up this ladder.
Alright, well, first we're gonna see what these attacks do.
Oh, fuck. We're dead.
Oh, okay, so it snags you with its tentacles. Make constitution saving throw.
This is the end.
just shy of what you needed to not be poisoned for 1 minute. And you take 8 damage. You are paralyzed.
I'm dead.
Oh, by the way, if that thing's attacking him, do I see it?
You have disadvantage, but yes, you can see its head as it is starting to eat your friend.
I will wonder if I should try shooting.
Where's that elf friend I have? Yeah.
13?
13 will hit.
Alright.
Even with disadvantage.
And 19.
And that will also hit. So 13 damage. Alright. And then it moves out of your line of sight, dragging the halfling's body with it.
Bye, friends.
Some bitch trying to steal my arrows.
Alright. Vertrum, back to your turn.
I guess I'm hopping down there. And now we have a rope there, so descending it should be relative.
So are you going to try to speed rappel?
Sure.
Give me athletics.
Athletics or acrobatics?
Athletics. This isn't really an acrobatic maneuver.
Well, how's that?
Yeah, that'll do. That'll do nicely, Ed.
I flip down there like an Olympic gymnast.
Yes, please tell me how exactly Bertram slides down.
Well, you see him grab his bow in his mouth since he just fired his arrows from it, jumps into the pool head first, grabbing hold of the rope, flipping upright. Sliding down there speedily, wrapping his legs around it. As he readies his bow and arrow again, stopping 5 feet up on the rope yet. So I should just be clearing the bottom of the tower, I believe. Or the tunnel.
Alright, Ed. Do you see yourself? Well, first off, if you don't have inspiration, give me inspiration. That was pretty epic.
Yeah, I still got it, though.
God damn you guys. Use your inspiration. It's the only way I can award anything to you. You guys don't get XP for killing anything.
Yeah. Let's see. Well, since I'm there again and got my bow already, I ain't gonna let loose an arrow. But first, I'm thinking maybe I should try the freebie draw magic stuff here. I'm gonna do this as like a bonus. Being a drow.
Alright, so feels dex. Really failed the deck save.
It is glowing.
What color?
I will go with the violet. Nice purplish color. That'd be nice.
There you go. So that means you get advantage on attacks.
That means everybody gets advantage in attacks.
Oh, okay. So that's your action. You've done your movement.
That was a bonus action.
For the draw.
Oh, okay. So advantage, which will help you there, because you need that.
Yep. 16 should connect for 3.
Alright.
Yeah, I did my movement.
Shrieks angrily, spitting out Serata, getting ready to poison itself to attack you. Santa!
Vasily?
Skip. Oh, why did it? Previous turn. Vasily.
He's still gone.
Step in the room just to see what the commotion is about. That's all.
I say mentally to Vasily, because I can do that. Hey, the halfling, it was stupid, fell down the hole, and now a big worm is eating him.
He would never be stupid enough to do that.
And then you just saw it probably stepped into the room just as and plunge head first with rope in hand down the shaft into the pool of water, I guess. That's what you would have seen.
Because the water's an illusion.
That should give him advantage on his checking against the illusion.
I don't think it actually works that way. Like, he still has to, like, overcome his own... Even being told that it's an illusion, he still has to...
Being shown a full-size elf diving into a pool that's, like, a foot deep?
Yeah. I suppose I'd probably grant it.
That's what I'm... I mean, being told it and being able to see it done should be advantage.
He can rationalize it in his mind.
What's Santa doing?
He is trying to figure out why everybody's playing in the kiddie pool over there. So, is this icon actually here, or is it somewhere else?
What icon? Bertram's
not there.
Bertram. Oh, yeah, sorry, Bertram's shouldn't be there. I'm not on the same map, so...
I'll come up here and, like, try to figure out if Bertram, like, just hit his head on the bottom of the pool.
So you're going to investigate?
I guess.
Yeah, you'd see the dark shaft with the rope hanging down through it.
A little flicker of light from my glowing dagger.
No,
he threw that up. That's right.
Alright, I'm done.
And Zo?
Zo's gonna do an athletic check. She's gonna jump down the rope and try to go down the rope as quickly as she can.
Can you use inspiration?
No, don't need it. She goes down the rope pretty easily and stops right above where Bertram is. Can she see the thing and shoot at it? Since I'm right on top of him, can I, like, shoot at it? Do I have, like, the ability? Do I have line of sight to do that?
Yeah, you can. Shiraz is prone and laying on the ground. 15 will hit. 8. Force damage.
24 is what hit the... You see him glowing in a white-violet hue. So he's easy to target.
And that is Zoe's turn.
Alright. Hits, Zoe?
No.
Its tentacles slap into you. 16 to hit. First off, make a... so you take 4 poison damage.
Okay.
And then make a constitution save. Okay, you feel like your joints lock up, but you shake it off.
Okay.
Serata, make a death save with disadvantage because you're poisoned.
Maybe use your inspiration and make it regular.
Yes, you have to declare inspiration before you make the roll. Okay, if you're going to use it.
I'm not going to declare inspiration yet.
Okay. Woof.
Could I use lucky? Wait, hold on.
Halfling luck is a roll of one, right?
Yeah, you get
yeah, that's a one. Shit. So what? That counts as one fail?
That's one failure.
Yep. All right.
All right, Bertram.
I'm thinking. Well, he backed away. I'm going to loose an arrow.
Didn't I get an attack of opportunity for him backing away?
Oh, sorry. It didn't back away. I backed it out of the way so that I could access the token.
Oh.
So yeah, you'd actually be in melee range now, Ed.
Okay. I will toss my longbow back here and pull out my short sword quickly and try to strike bone. 15
will hit. 3 piercing.
And then I give it a twist.
Stabbing with a twist.
I always want to add the twist.
Just silly?
I'll approach the well that everyone else has disappeared down to. Get a hold of the rope and start descending.
Are you trying to do it quickly?
No.
Oh, okay.
No need
Santa?
Doesn't he have to make an investigation check first? To see
I'm just following a rope.
Can Santa possibly jump below Vasily? Try to grab the rope below Vasily and descend?
That's, well, possibly. It's 8 feet around. So you basically try to jump around him and then hope that you can grab the rope. I would definitely ask for an athletics check on that one.
All right, I'll do that and use my inspiration.
Okay.
13.
You barely grab a hold. Manage. And I'll give you the inspiration back because that's gotta look pretty badass.
Or it could have looked really bad.
Yeah, if you had gotten that 6, it would have been a case of you just slamming into a wall and bounce back and forth and down the shaft.
All right, I suppose I'm done.
Okay.
Do I make it to the bottom?
Zoe?
Can you ping me to where I am?
Oh, yeah.
I am going to, I'm still on the rope, right?
And Sarada's right under the creature?
No, you're down. You're down on the ground.
Oh, I thought I was still on the rope.
No.
Okay, well,
Is Sarada still under the creature?
Yup.
You hear some muffled moaning.
Can I see Sarada?
Alright, you have 3 hit points.
Plus 3. negative two now?
Nope.
No, you'd be at three.
Oh, okay, three.
Yeah, there's no negatives.
Okay, so is it my turn yet?
Yeah, sorry. It would be. Hold on a second.
Because I thought you said it was my turn and then other people were doing stuff, so.
Yeah, okay, well, yeah, it is your turn.
No, because that negates what I was about to do. So, anyways, I guess I'm gonna bash this thing with my quarterstaff two-handedly. Because Eldritch Blast would get me. Wait, Eldritch Blast would get me,
disadvantage.
But that would be normal because we have advantage on the thing.
Right, right.
Inspiration.
You gotta declare it before you roll.
Yeah, he's doing it the written down rule book.
Oh, okay. Well, then I don't use inspiration, and it was the first one. I missed.
Alright, Virtrum, here comes a tentacle bite combo.
Hopefully, just four ones.
19 will hit, so there's 5 poison damage. Roll a constitution save.
Constitution. Just click it.
Is that a constitution save?
I don't know, that's constitution I clicked.
Oh, you should.
Saving throws, okay, I see.
Yeah, because you might have a better saving throw than. not this time. No. So you are poisoned and paralyzed. And then, so you took that 5 damage, and then you take an additional 9 as it starts to munch on you. Ooh. In a fashion that you find unpleasant. Sarada, you are awake, though still poisoned.
Yeah, I groan really hard. I'm like, get this fucker off me.
Well, you can punch it from your prone position, I suppose.
Guess. I mean, can I use inspiration to, like, get out of it? Or, like, make a dex check to try and...
scramble behind it?
Yeah, considering that I'm a halfling.
Sure.
My halfling. Okay.
Acrobatics with advantage then.
Okay.
Oh, well, yeah. You go ahead and position yourself wherever you want behind it.
Alrighty.
And now it is Vertram's turn. Since you're paralyzed, so you're incapacitated. I believe you get to make